This video presents key concepts related to tables, which are fundamental components of the ServiceNow platform. Click an item to go directly to that topic, or continue watching to cover all topics. The ServiceNow platform is built on a relational database, which is a collection of data items organized into tables such that data can be accessed and reassembled in many different ways without having to reorganize the underlying database tables. Both data and application functionality are stored in the same database to provide an enterprise-wide automated service model with one user interface, a single system of record to define, offer, and manage enterprise services. A table is a collection of records in the database. For example, here's the user table. The individual pieces of data in a record are fields. Each field in a record corresponds to a column in a table. Each field describes one element of the record, such as the user's name or email address. Each record corresponds to a row in the table, in this case, information about a single user, and is identified by a 32-character, globally unique ID called a Sys ID. Each field has three attributes, a label, a name, and a value. The label is a user-friendly term that allows people to identify the field, such as user ID or location, in the user interface. The name is a unique term that the system uses to identify the field in scripts and automated business processes. For example, the name attribute of the location field on the user table is sysuser.location. Don't confuse the name attribute with the name field on the user table, which is a label. The name attribute of the name field on the user table is sysuser.name. Values are the actual data, such as this user's name, Charlie Jones, or his location in Colorado. In some cases, the value may be empty or null. There are many different types of fields, which are listed in the product documentation. For example, here on the user form, we see string fields, whose values can include letters, numbers, and other characters, choice fields, which contain values selected from a limited list of options, and a reference field, which references data in another table. In this case, the department values come from the department table. ServiceNow applications use tables and records to manage data and processes, such as incident, problem, and CMDB. Let's take a look. Data from tables is displayed in the content frame in many different formats. Here's the default view of the incident list, filtered to show all open records from the incident table. Default list views don't show every field from the corresponding table, just those relevant to the process. List views can be configured by system administrators and further personalized by individual users to display the fields they prefer to see. Data is also displayed in forms, one record at a time. Users with the proper roles can view and edit data here. Not all fields from the table are displayed on the form, but administrators can configure which fields appear here. This report provides a graphic summary of our open incidents by priority. Pointing to chart sectors displays a summary of the data, and clicking a sector lists the underlying data. Users with the admin or specialized admin roles can view the system tables. Like fields, each table has a unique, user-friendly label, which allows people to identify the table in the user interface, and a unique name, which allows the system to identify the table in scripts and automated business processes. Tables can extend other tables, creating parent and child tables. A table that extends another table is called a child class, and the table it extends is the parent class. The task table and configuration table are examples of parent classes that are extended to child classes. For example, here are child tables extended from the task table. They include change request, incident, and problem. And here are child tables that extend the configuration item table. They include database, hardware, and software. If a table is extended, but itself is not extending another table, it is called a base class. The task table is such a table, making it both a parent and a base class. A child table inherits the fields of its parent. These fields are stored in the parent class. A child table may also contain some fields that are unique to that child class. These fields are stored in the child class. Each record in a child class exists with the same Sys ID in both the child class and its parent class, and both are always accessed together as one record by the platform. So this means that when a record in one class is deactivated or deleted, the platform automatically deactivates or deletes its counterpart in the corresponding parent or child class, as well as in any other extending or extended tables containing the same record. Tables that exist in the base system are called core tables, so both task and incident are core tables. And as we've seen, the task table is also a parent and base table. Tables that are created by system administrators and do not exist in the base system are custom tables. Here's a table our system administrator created to track employee guests, the number of people in their party, and their menu choices for the upcoming holiday party. And here's the form designed to collect and view the information. A field on a table can get its value from another table. Here, the guest field on the company holiday party table gets its value from the name field of the user table. Thus, guest is called a reference field, and the user table is a reference table. Because they have a relationship, these tables are also referred to as related tables. Here's another example. The incident table contains a caller field, whose value comes from the user table. So we could call the incident table the target table and the user table the source table. A schema map provides a graphic view of relationships among tables. For example, here's the schema map for the task table. It identifies reference and extension relationships depending on which of these checkboxes are selected. Here's the task table. Its yellow color identifies it as the selected table. Each related table has a colored bar indicating the relationship to the selected table. For example, this table extends the task table, this one references the task table, and this one is referenced by the task table. Pointing to a connector line displays the details of the relationship between the two tables. Sometimes it's helpful to limit the graphic to one relationship type at a time. For example, here are all the tables referenced by the task table. Earlier, we said the task table doesn't extend any other table. It's a base class. So we shouldn't see any tables listed here. And we don't. This concludes our video. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community. For cost-effective training solutions, contact ServiceNow Education Services.